So far, my favorite female characters in Injustice 2 are, naturally, the Gotham City Sirens, Poison Ivy, Harley Quinn, and then Catwoman, in that order. But I am in the market for some more firepower, and I believe Starfire can deliver. Her time is coming! You might have noticed they're doing a much stronger push for her these days in the comics. A particularly cool shot of her, by the way, in Super Sons number 6 this week. I thought she looked particularly awesome. But let's see this, and then we can discuss in depth. Oh, I'm so excited! Okay, I can't wait. You know, she's such a peaceful character, we hardly ever see her kick butt. I'm excited to see what they came up with for her fighting. I hope it includes... Oh, right! Yes!
You're burning the wrong bridges.
I want none with Dick Grayson's killer.
It was an personal accident.
You took away my boy toy! Oh. Oh wow, see, I've never seen her do that. She has lightsaber hands. Wow. It's fun. We should watch her fight at night. Ooh, fireworks show. The super move gonna be? I like the fire circle effect that it, oh, what's that? When it went around her, she creates, okay. She's very upset. Oh, that's fantastic. Move over, Dazzler. That's like taking jazz hands to a new level. She looks so cool. Let's go to that final shot there. That's fantastic. You know, when they first debuted the character, I said she looked a little bit like Jennifer Lopez, but she moves like Beyonce. I wouldn't be surprised, you know, if that was an influence there. She has like this rock star, but like a specific, well, Beyonce basically, you know, because like Taylor Swift doesn't move like that, or Katy Perry, right? But this, like, I guess we would say a diva quality to her, where, you know, that walk, that slow walk she does at the end, where, you know, she's like she's putting on a show. I think that's a really interesting choice, and you haven't seen that with, I mean, I think that the Gotham City Sirens are very sexy, but this to me was like, I guess because it's like a good girl sexy, which is interesting, you know, because like, I'm sure some of you are like, oh, Grace, what are you talking about? Supergirl's very sexy, etc. But, you know, Gotham City Sirens specialize in, you know, bad girl sexy. And, you know, Starfire is, she's just nice. She's just a nice person, right? I think the costume's really great, as I've said before. You know, I think it shows off a lot of skin, which Starfire is supposed to do. You know, every time I talk about Starfire, without fail, someone goes, but you're such a strong, you know, girl power, you know, person, Grace. How can you be okay with someone who's dressed in such skimpy clothing? That's the character. You know, this is the character responsible. We just talked about it earlier in the Young Justice video for Dick Grayson's sexual awakening in Titans. I mean, it was an iconic moment for both characters. I mean, we're talking about someone who learns languages by making out with someone, right? It's for educational purposes. And so I think that needs to be reflected in the character. And I think this is a great choice. It has like a swimsuit, rock star, diva kind of feel to it, but also I think works as a superhero costume. I like the reflective panels on it. As you can see, you know, it's also not unreasonable that it would stay up and that she would be able to move in it without having any accidents, right? You know, from the high sides on the bottom to the way the top is still manages to be anchored. I thought it was great. I really liked it. And as I said, you know, they've had tremendous success with female characters in the DCEU. Harley Quinn, Wonder Woman, Mira's coming up. There was an action figure and a Barbie doll that debuted at Comic-Con already on the show floor. And they've greenlit a Batgirl movie with Joss Whedon. And I wouldn't be surprised if Starfire, I mean, I know that she's going to be in the new live-action Titans show that they're streaming, but I would hope that they would have even bigger plans for her. They often try out these characters on the small screen before graduating them to the big screen. For instance, as they did some degree with Harley Quinn. But anyway, or some other Suicide Squad members, but it wouldn't be impossible, like it would be at Marvel, for her to debut on the small screen and then eventually get pushed up to the movies. I think she'd look great. And I think just like there was a big fight to play Poison Ivy when they introduced that character back in the day, I think there would be a big fight for this character as well. I particularly because it might maybe go to a Latina actress, which I think would be very exciting. Look at those boots. That's a great effect. You know, Starfire is very, you know, very fashion savvy because that, the way the mirrored thing on the boot goes creates an elongated look for her leg. She knows her angles. She knows how to make sure she looks good. So I like it. I think this looks like a lot of fun to play, and I think I might have a new favorite alongside the Gotham City Sirens. What do you think? What do you like about it? Do you think Starfire, her time is coming? And be sure to write your thoughts down below. As always, thank you for watching with me, and you can check out more Comic-Con coverage right now.